Hi, this is Andy Cobb with the Intel Corporation, and in this video, I will be going over the process of configuring your first Intel Endpoint Management Assistant tenant. Let's start out with talking about the tenant setup process. There are some things we need to do to get going. First, we need to create some configurations. We need a configuration for AMT. Note, the AMT configuration applies to both Intel AMT and ISM platforms. We need a configuration for an endpoint group, and optionally, we can define a configuration for AMT auto configuration. And once we have got the configuration defined, we will deploy them using the Intel EMA agent, allowing management of devices. The Intel AMT configuration defines how Intel AMT behaves. We have the option of configuring AMT in SIRA or TLS mode, as well as settings that we want to make to ensure that AMT works the way we need it to in the environment. We will go into more details of what this looks like in the demo later in this video. When managing a tenant within Intel EMA, you need to understand the idea of device groups or endpoint groups. Endpoint groups allow organizing together of the computers you are managing. That could be physical location or by functional groups, such as computers used by the finance team or lab computers. An endpoint group configuration defines which in-band management features are enabled. So, if you want to turn on user consent or disable remote KVM control, this is where we go and define the policy for the in-band agent. It is important to note that these policies cannot be changed after the endpoint group is created. Optionally, we can enable automatic configuration of AMT when an AMT device is registered with an endpoint group, which occurs when an EMA agent is installed on the device. First, place a check in the Enable box. Choose the Intel AMT profile from the drop-down menu. Choose your activation method, and that can be either host-based or certificate-based. Set the administrator password. You have the option of randomizing the password for enhanced security. This password allows the remote connection to Intel AMT. If certificate provisioning is chosen, another option comes up to randomize the Intel MEBX password. All Intel AMT and ISM devices support some type of pre-boot environment, where you have the option of going into the Management Engine BIOS extension or MEBX. MEBX is a kind of diagnostic screen that allows manual configuration of AMT. Similar to above, you have the option of randomizing the password. In a production environment, we recommend hardening systems against physical attacks by preventing a person that gets a hold of the system from getting into the Management Engine BIOS extensions and changing around any of the AMT configurations. However, if working in a test or a lab environment where MEBX access may be needed and the hassle of looking up the random password from Intel EMA server is too much hassle, there is the option of not randomizing that password. Again, that is not recommended for production environments. That is only acceptable in test environments or labs. And finally, at the very bottom is certificate details, where you can pick the provisioning certificate that you would like to use. There are two provisioning modes for AMT and ISM. We are not going to go into a ton of detail about them, but I want to cover some high-level things to keep in mind as you decide how you want to manage the configuration of Intel AMT or ISM. We support host-based provisioning, also known as client control mode, or certificate provisioning, also known as admin control mode. Host-based provisioning is the easiest option to go with. You do not have to have any provisioning certificates. It works great across the internet, without any additional client or network configuration, but the one consideration to keep in mind is user consent. If you're going to use boot redirection to boot into BIOS or do remote KVM control, these management actions require obtaining user consent before you can do these things. Intel AMT and ISM has a built-in mechanism for obtaining user consent from the end user. With certificate provisioning or admin control mode, a provisioning certificate is required before you can use this mode. The certificate is used to help authenticate that the system is being activated by an authorized party. The benefit you get when you do certificate provisioning or admin control mode is that user consent becomes optional. User consent can be turned on or off as needed. When working with a system where a person is not present, user consent can be turned off remotely for that one time or leave it off entirely based on your preference. Once the AMT configuration is defined, the endpoint group created, and optionally auto-setup configured, we can deploy the EMA agent. The agent installation files page has a few options to choose from. Here we see an option for choosing the version of the agent. Along with downloading the appropriate Windows Service version of the Intel EMA agent for your architecture, we will also download the policy file. The policy file has all the unique settings that define which endpoint group the device should go into and how to configure AMT. Once we have the two files together on the system in the same location, we run the EMA agent executable as an administrator. The executable will read the policy file to configure the device and register the device with the EMA server. With that, let's go through a demo of the tenant configurations. Log in using a tenant administrator username and password. The first time you log in to a new tenant, you are brought to this overview screen, where you can set up the various profiles needed to get Intel Endpoint Management Assistant environment up and running to manage devices. First thing I want to do is upload a provisioning certificate because I want to be able to do admin control mode provisioning or certificate-based provisioning of Intel AMT. I will choose the file. I will give it a friendly name and the password needed to decrypt the file to upload it. Now that that is done, I can hit upload. And here we see that my new PKI provisioning certificate has been added into the system here. With that, let's go back to the overview screen. What I'd like to do next is to create a new Intel AMT profile. So I will go ahead and click on that option and choose new AMT profile here. On the screen, I will start out by figuring out the options I want to use. So here I have the option of choosing a TLS security or client-initiated remote access. There are two settings available for SIRA. The first and default setting enables SIRA regardless of the domain the device is connected to. The second setting only enables SIRA when the device is not connected to a specific domain. For this demo, I am going to stick with the default option of client-initiated remote access. For example, when a device is on-site connected to the local network, give the profile a name and a description. Next, I will step through the different settings. For power states, I am going to leave the default option selected. Here I will choose the management interfaces I want to enable for this configuration profile. Let's select all of them. I will leave FQDN source as the default, shared with the host OS. Likewise, I will leave the IP address option as from the DHCP server. Just to save some time, I'm going to skip over the Wi-Fi and 802.1x profiles. Now that is done, I can go down here and click the Save button. And I see my new AMT configuration profile here on the screen. Now I will go to the Endpoint Groups tab and create a new endpoint group. Click the New Endpoint Group button. Give the group a name. I'm going to use the AMT profile name to keep things simple. Enter a description. Set the password that will be used to change the policy if needed at a later date. Now I will choose the policy options I want to enable. Similar to what I did with the AMT profile, I'm going to select all the options here and I am also going to turn off the user consent option. Again, this is just a demo environment where I am not concerned about user consent. Now that is done, I'm going to go up to the top of the page here and click on Save an Intel AMT Auto Setup. This is the optional setup that you can do in your environment if you want to be able to automatically configure Intel AMT whenever a new device is reported into the EMA server. I like to use this, so I'm going to check the Enable box. I have only one AMT profile, so that is all that will show up in this drop-down menu. For activation method, because I have uploaded certificate, I have the option to choose certificate provisioning. I will select that. Now I'm going to set the administrator password that will be used to communicate with AMT on my devices. I am using a simple password for this demo, but we always recommend that you set a complex password per industry best practices or your IT requirements. And we have another option that appears when we choose the certificate provisioning or admin control mode, and that is the ability to set a random password for the MEBX configuration. The MEBX, again, is a BIOS screen that you can enter to configure AMT or to turn AMT off. In production environments, we always recommend sending a random password, and we provide a way to pull that password out of the database if you need it. However, in my environment, I am doing a lot of testing, so I'm going to choose the Do Not Set the Password option, which does not alter the existing password. And here, I choose the AMT provisioning certificate. Again, because I'm doing certificate provisioning or admin control mode, I have to choose a certificate. I only have one certificate, so it is selected by default. Hit save. And we're just about ready to go. From the endpoint group screen, we can come over here to the Create Agent Files option. Click on the down arrow and select Create Agent Files from the drop-down menu. That takes us to a screen where we can download the appropriate Windows service and the agent policy file. I will choose the 64-bit service. Click Download. Likewise for the agent policy file. I have already downloaded these on a test client in my lab, and I'm going to show you what the installation of the agent looks like. Okay, here is my client device I will be installing the EMA agent on. Right-click on the EMA agent executable file and choose to run as administrator. Click Yes at the Windows User Account Control dialog. Then the installation screen comes up. We can validate the policy that the device will be registered with. Now that I have verified that, hit the Install button. All right, the EMA agent screen disappeared, signaling that the installation has completed, and I'm ready to go back to the EMA web console to confirm that the system shows up. I have come back to the endpoint screen, and here you can see the device that we just installed the agent on has appeared in the endpoint group. It is connected, and the AMT status is not provisioned. However, that should change into the provision state once the provisioning process completes. This concludes our demo of EMA tenant configuration and agent installation process. Thank you for watching, and keep an eye out for the next video.